What's good, everybody? It's Jay Carfi on the vid, back with another hip-hop blog for you guys. First off, big shout out once again to my moderator, Murder Man. Always put me up on game. But this was a surprise to me. I did a video, we're talking about a legend in hip-hop, man. I did a video a couple weeks back about Dr. Dre. No, not NWA, not Aftermath, you know what I mean? We're talking about Dr. Dre, Original Concept, Yo MTV Raps, all that, you know what I mean? I did a video on him a couple weeks ago, speaking about the Vlad TV interview he had just did, where he was pushing his book, you know, and speaking about Def Jam back in the day, Russell Simmons, Rick Rubin, you know, things that went down behind the scenes, being on tour with the Beastie Boys, being their DJ, all kinds of, you know, hip hop history. And in that video, I was kind of saying, man, it sucks to see Ed Lover like this. You know, he's like, I remember them days. I was very, very young, but I still remember them days, you know, but it's like we forget about Ed Lover. A lot of us, I feel like we do, you know what I mean? Because we don't see him that much nowadays currently. But when I saw him on that Vlad video and, you know, they were talking about how he is blind from type 2 diabetes. And I see him pushing this book and, you know, he spoke about his contract and everything that happened within hip hop, his record deal and how he basically kind of got robbed. I was like, man, it's a shame to see a legend like this, you know, like doesn't get mentioned that much in the conversation currently about hip hop in this internet era. And he's trying really hard to push this book. And when I say that, I'm not trying to belittle the man or play the man, but you could just tell he's kind of hurting, right? Well, I was totally unaware of how he's really like been broke down from the diabetes. I didn't know. I thought he was just losing his eyesight. You guys comment and let me know if you were aware of all of this, but he's lost a lot more than that. But he seems to be in very, very good spirits. But basically, he said it all started dating back to 2007. He was walking around his home barefoot and stepped on a tack from underneath some carpeting. And just was like, oh, it's nothing, you know, cut my big toe. I'll put some Neosporin on it. I'll be good money. But that's not what happened. He ended up, you know, over a month down the road, weeks, over a month later, being very sick. It kept getting infected. And he found out, man, like this diabetes is crushing me, and had to have the toe amputated. He also ended up also losing a leg, another just accident, lost his balance, misjudged, like coming down a stairway, like at a family function for a holiday, went to grab the railing, missed, slipped, fell. Someone tried to, you know, hold him up, break his fall. He ended up kind of like twisting his ankle, and next thing you know, same thing happened, that like what happened with this toe. He kept getting infections to the point where it was eating away at the bones and everything in his feet. And they had to cut his leg off, as you'll see in one of the pictures. And it's just crazy, man. We hear about diabetes and, you know, how it's like an epidemic. Many people suffer and die and things like that because of diabetes. And, you know, it sounds like Ed Lover was also saying he tries to, you know, spread awareness. And he also talked about changing his diet, trying to be more of a vegetarian, staying away from soda. Most people call it soda. I call it pop, but I started saying soda because no one never knows what I'm talking about when I say pop. And just trying to, you know, eat right and everything. And he actually went on to also say that the late, great comic, and not just comic icon and legend, he did way more than that. Talking about Dick Gregory, you know, helped guide him and give him some game onto how to manage the diabetes. And it's just like I said, I just didn't realize he had went through all of this. You know what I mean? Like, it's a shame that he went down this road. But he also, you know, when speaking to the media, mentioned how he's always kind of been overweight, but it never bothered him. You know what I mean? Like, being a fat guy, it never bothered him. He was content. He was cool with it. And, you know, I always say all the time, people obsess about their looks and everything like that way too much. But in his situation, you know, he was becoming a diabetic, and he talked about that, how he didn't realize what was happening. He wasn't really educated and up on diabetes. And if he could kind of have things, do them all over again, he would have did things differently, because he didn't realize the damage he was doing to his body and that it was reversible, you know? So just wanted to share this with all the hip hop fans out there. As you guys know who follow my channel, I stay dropping hip hop content, sports content, news, all kinds of stuff on the channel. But this also is just good to share for anyone, you know, who may be going through this in their life. Like, you're a borderline diabetic, or you're not in the best of health. You feel like you might be getting to that point. And I get it, man. Life is very stressful, can be very overwhelming. It's hard to get by. You know what I mean? I totally get it. And there's a lot of other things going on in the world. But if you're in that boat, don't ignore it. You know what I mean? Get on it now and do what you can to get yourself healthy. Same thing like with exercising. You can exercise. You don't have to go hard. You don't got to be a gym rat in there every day going nuts, doing 2 hours of cardio and making sure you're hitting arm day, leg day, back day, whatever, shoulder day. You know what I mean? You don't have to do it like that. Just get, you know, do some walking every day, or do some light cardio or whatever. You know what I mean? There's a lot of ways to get some exercise and help your overall health, so you don't end up in this boat like Dr. Dre, you know. But all in all, as I was stating earlier in the video, he seems to be happy, in good spirits, you know, didn't get down, didn't get depressed, and is, you know, doing the right things now, and just wishes that he would have did them sooner. But he said he's got a lot more to do, like the journey isn't over. So I don't know, man. Like, I just wanted to share this story. You know, as I stated, I covered him in a video recently about the Vlad interview. You guys get in the comments. Let me know if you watch the Vlad interviews. Let me know if you read the book. Let me know your favorite moments from Yo MTV Raps. Let me know if you were aware of like how poor that his health was. As I stated, I knew when I made the first video that he was blind or going blind. I'm not totally sure if he's 100% blind, you know, from the previous interviews where I saw where he was speaking about being blind. From the way he was speaking on it, it led me to believe that he hadn't lost all eyesight, but he very well may have. But man, you know, diabetes is a joke, but it don't have to go down that way. You know, it is reversible. So get in the comments, guys. New viewers, make sure to sub to the channel. It's Jay Coffee, man. Join Team Coffee. Like I said, we drop so much content, and I just want to kick it with you guys and hear what the people got to say in them comments. You know what I mean? And tap in on my lives. We open up the phone lines. You can call in, all that. Join Team Coffee, guys. Thanks for watching. Peace.